Hello guys, and welcome back to a new episode of the Architects 3DP Mega series. For those who don't know the project,
the Architects 3DP Mega is a big size and industrial quality 3D printer that I'm designing and building step by step from scratch along this series here at Architects 3DP.
This project is only being possible thanks to my Patreon supporters that help me keep going month to month,
and the amazing sponsors of the Architects 3DP Mega that you can see on screen. In the last video, I started the build of the Y-axis of the printer, where we installed the Hewin railings as well as the skates. Also the 3D printed components that will go on the front and the back of the Y rails. We finished the video with the installation of the Y belt tensioners, and that's from where we're going to continue today. In the episode 13, we are going to finish the build of the Y axis and plan the next steps with the build of the Mega.
So the first thing we're going to do is to jump to the back of the Mega and install the two NEMA 17 stepper motors that are going to power the axis.
They are going to be installed right here from the bottom, using some washers and M3x10mm bolts. So once set, we'll insert the motor, with the cable facing to the exterior, and we'll insert all four screws. Remember that it's always better to tighten them diagonally. Next step will be to install the pulleys on top. Remember that it has to have 5mm bore, as we saw in the last episode. So here we go! The pulley is ready to go. Now, on the other side, we'll insert the motor from the bottom, we'll install the four bolts, and finally we'll install the pulley on top as we just did on the other side.
Alright, so now we have most of the static parts of the Y-axis installed, and what I'm gonna do now is to bring back the X-axis bridge and place it on top of the skates.
The axis is quite heavy, but once we have it on top of the skates, we'll be able to move it back and forth very easily.
Now we're going to install a very important component before finishing the assembly of the Y-axis. But before, I'm going to talk to you about today's sponsor, PCB Way.
In this video, I'm going to talk to you about their campaign Share Your Order Feedback, that you will find linked at the beginning of the description of the video. PCB Way is asking to all their clients to post their orders and share their design, innovation and creativity in order to be able to win one of the fantastic prizes that you are watching on screen. You can enter until the end of the year, and the winners will be announced on January 14th. Don't wait to make your first order and share your order feedback with everyone. Through the link in the description, you will find more information about how to enter and the rules.
Alright, so back to the Mega. The next parts are, as I was saying, very important for the build. And the parts I'm talking about are the belt clamps that are going to be installed on each of the skates of the Y-axis.
So to install them, as you can see, we'll need an M4x40mm bolt together with two M4 washers and an M4 nylock nut. All this combined, of course, with the 3D printed belt clamp we designed and you'll be able to download from the link in the description. Alright, so we'll present it in place just like so, since later we'll need to attach the GT2 belt. Now, as always, we'll repeat the same process on the other side. And we'll be able to bring the X-axis bridge back on top of the skates just like so.
At this point, we need to attach both parts together. And for that, we're going to use 4 M5 bolts and 4 M5 nylock nuts for each of the sides of the Y-axis.
We'll insert the bolts from top and the nuts from the bottom, tightening everything together. And once we have one side done, we're going to continue with the other one.
Alright, so we have just finished putting together both the X and Y axes. That means that we have finished the Cartesian axis, and in theory, each of the extruders should be able to move to every point of the print bed. As you can see, the movement is very smooth and satisfying, but let's continue with the build.
We have this bunch of cables coming out of each of the ends of the X-axis. So now we are going to run them to the back of the printer, using this nice cable chain that we printed. So the first step will be to open the cable chain. Once we got it, we're gonna connect one of the ends of the cable chain to the 3D printed end of the X-axis, just like so. The next step will be to insert all the cables inside the cable chain, but try to do it as much organized as you can, so you won't have any problems later on. Once we got them in, we'll install a couple cable chain caps to keep everything in place, and then put all the other caps in place. It is starting to look very nice, isn't it? Okay, so once we have the first portion of the cable chain full, we're going to move the axis back and continue with the rest of the chain using the same method.
Okay guys, so I'm going to skip this part because I don't want to bore you, but after 10 minutes or so putting everything together, I've got to this point.
Where I have the cable chain completely assembled, and what I'm gonna do now is to bend it over to direct it to the back of the Y-axis as I announced before. Here at the back we'll have to insert all the cables one by one. And as I said, please be all the organized that you can. Once we have them, we'll connect the last chain link to the 3D printed part we installed in the last episode, and we'll be ready to go with this side. Guys, as you can see, this is starting to look amazing. Now you can guess what are we doing next, right? The other side. As you can see, here it is waiting for us, but lucky you, I saved you a lot of time watching me putting together all the cables, because here we have the Y-axis cable chain full of cables and ready to connect to the back, you guys.
I'm going to do that off camera, but guys, try to be as organized as you can, it is very important. Alright, so once we have both cable chains in place and the X-axis attached to the structure, we need to do one more thing to every component we installed in the last two episodes, and it's, now yes, to tighten the bolts.
So we'll have to tighten everything, as I said, from the bolts holding the human railings to the structure, till the bolts holding the 3D printed parts on the end of each axis. It's gonna take us a while, but once we finish, everything should be very robust and smooth, and hopefully will work like a charm. Alright, so the last touches here at the back, and
it looks fantastic, isn't it? We have attached the motors at the back, the belt tensioners at the front, and the clamps on the skates. But there is a very important part missing, and is the next one that we are going to install, and is the GT2 belt.
So as I was saying, the GT2 belt is going to start in the skate, go through the tensioner, passing next to the skate again, but without touching it, pass through the motor, and finally go to the skate again. I have passed the GD2 belt through the elements, and the last and more difficult step will be to attach it to the skates of the y-axis right here in the middle. So the first step will be to release all the pressure on the clamp. Then grab one side, then the other, and finally tighten everything back. To make it a little bit easier, what I've done is to bend the belt with the teeth facing out and fix it with a zip tie. That way we'll increase the friction of the belt with the 3D printed parts. Alright, so now that the first is in place, we're going to measure and put the zip ties on the second. And here we go. Now we'll just have to tighten the bolt.
The very last step with this belt is going to be to tighten it. So we'll make use of the tensioning mechanism that we designed on the front of the printer.
So once said, we're going to go for it. We'll just tension this nut till the belt has enough tension on it. Now, once again, we'll do the same on the other side.
Okay guys, so our y-axis is almost complete. We just need to make the last touches and we'll be ready to go.
One of the last and very easy steps is going to be to install the green caps that came with the Hewin railings, and Damen CNC, our biggest sponsor for this build, provided at the beginning of this project. Please go and check out their great store through the link in the description of the video. First one side, and then the other one.
Okay guys, so we have reached the end of this episode. Remember that you will find the links for the STL files down in the description of the video. And guys, I just wanted to ask you to share this video in social media, groups, etc. since it is quite difficult to run a channel like this, especially after 2 years of inactivity. Finally, I want to give a huge shout out to our Patreon supporters for making this channel possible. Please consider joining them to support the channel as well and make Architects 3D bigger. And guys, see you in the next video.